Hello guys. Today this lesson is based on your second order differential equations, maths and five. Okay, this is question six, usually 6.2 of your final examination. So before we get into it, I just want to highlight a few things which are very important. Remember, integration. If we remember how we did integration in maths and four, we would take the table for. Remember, we had a table like this. Let me write it here. We had table like this. We had y, we had dy dx. That's all we had in maths and four. Now in maths and five and n6, you guys are just blessed. Everything is given to you. So we had a table like this. We had, I'll give example. We had let's say k. Okay, let's say x, and we had one, and we had, for example, let's say sine x, and we had cos x. We said it's negative sine. We had tan. We said it's x squared. This is the table, not the entire table, just example, but we had something like this. So we knew if I'm looking for derivative, I will check this side and go to this side. But if I'm looking for the integral, I must check under dy dx and go backwards. Like for example, the integral of cos is sine, integral of sec squared is tan, but the derivative of tan is sec squared, which is the opposite. So that's when we concluded that integration is the opposite to differentiation. Not that it's our own theory, no, it's maths, but we also understood the same thing, right? Okay, so this is what I'm trying to highlight here. Under when I said from y, if we derive, we get dy dx. This is a mistake. From dy dx, if I derive it again respect to x, I'm getting the second derivative of that, right? But now if I'm taking it from the second derivative going backwards, now it's integration. From second derivative going back, I will get first derivative, then integrate it again, I'm getting y. So this is what we will be doing in your second order differential equation. This I believe is the easiest for in this course. I believe it's the easiest you can do in this course. So let me give you a quick example. First of all, you will have the second derivative. Let's say second derivative is x plus 1. So the first thing you have to do, make sure next to dy dx you have only 1 multiplying it. That's the first thing you must do. Then after that, from dy, if you have one now, you integrate. But when you integrate, you don't show the integrals and you just do it. You know, from the second derivative, I'm going to first derivative. We know, I know for me to get here, I integrated. So now if I integrate x, I'm getting x squared over 2. If I'm integrating 1, I'm getting x. Then don't forget, you have to add plus c always, constant. Now if I'm integrating this again, I'm getting y. Now, if I integrate x squared, I'm getting x cubed over 3. But that over 3 will find over 2 in the bottom, which will make it 6. If I integrate x, I'm getting x squared over 2. If I integrate c, because it's a constant, I'll get cx. Now there is another constant, which is d. So now this is your final answer here. So this is called a general solution. If they want you to get the particular solution, they will give you values to help you calculate C and D. Then that will be your particular solution. Okay, let's get started. Okay, that's your first question. Remember, the first thing you must do. Okay, let's analyze it. The first thing we must do is get rid of 4 there. The second part is to change 1 over cos 2. We know 1 over cos is the same as, will be the same as sec squared because it's cos squared. So let's do. The first thing we're doing is dividing by 4. So if I divide 2 by 4, I'm getting 1 over 2. then I still have this. Here, if I divide 1 by 4, I get 1 over 4. Remember, we're changing cos squared to sec squared. Then if I divide 4.8 by 4, I'm getting 1.2. You see, so far we haven't integrated anything. We just simplified so that we can be able to work with it. So now let's integrate. If I integrate the second derivative, I get the first derivative. If I integrate e, remember the answer will be e exponent that divide by 3. So this will make it e exponent 3x divide by 3. That 3 and this 2 will be 6. This is 1 over 6. Then the next one, now I'm integrating sec squared. If you check the integral of sec squared, I just showed you the table. The integral of sec squared is tan squared. Because you go check under the derivative and you go backwards. So the integral of sec squared is tan, not tan squared. Because if you check the derivative of tan, it's sec squared, which means the integral of sec squared will be tan. But this will be tan 3x over 3. That over 3 will make this over 12 because we have over 4. Now 1.2 is just a constant, so we'll just put x then plus c because we are integrating. Now the next step. Okay, now we integrate the first derivative. Sorry, I will get y. Now, if I integrate e exponent 3x, I'm getting e exponent 3x over 3, but that over 3 will get 6 in the bottom, which will make it 18. Now, I'm integrating tan. I know I have to divide by that 3, so I'll have 1 over 36. Now, the integral of tan, we check, it's ln sec. And you guys should practice how to use the formula sheet correct. Now the integral of x, it will be x squared over 2. Integral of c, it's cx plus d. Now that's your final answer there. And please make sure if you don't understand, just pause the video and go through it again and again. Because believe me, this question 6 is the easiest question and you cannot afford to get it wrong. So make sure you get it. Okay, let's move. Now I'm going to particular solution because most questions are particular solutions. So particular solutions, it means we will have to get C and that D, those two constants. So now they give us this. We know from this we have to get dy dx and get y. Then they told you if dy dx is 1 and x is 1 and y is 1. So let's get started. So the first one, the coefficient of second derivative is 1, so we don't have to change anything. So we go straight to getting dy dx. Integrate 3x squared, we're getting 3x cubed over 3. Integrate 2x, we're getting 2x squared over 2. Don't forget plus c. So do you see we can solve for c already because they told you that dy dx is 1 and x is 1. So let's solve for c. This is 1. 3 and 3 will cancel. So it will be, let me just simplify it here. Dy dx will be x cubed minus x squared plus c. So now I'm substituting dy dx is 1, x cubed minus x squared plus c. So do you see our c is 1? Because 1 and 1 will cancel. So now if I go back substitute here, this is our equation. Now next step is to integrate again. Remember we are looking for a particular solution, which means we are looking for y. So if I integrate again, I get y. Integrate x cubed, it's x4 over 4. Integrate x squared, it's x cubed over 3. Integrate 1, I'm getting x. Then plus d, it's another constant. Remember this one was c, Then if we didn't have c, we would have cx plus d, right? But now we already have c, so we add d. Then we have to solve that d. They're saying our y is 1, our x is 1, 1 exponent 4 is 1 over 4 minus 1 over 3 plus 1 plus d. So I'll press my calculator and solve d real quick. So we can see 1 and 1 will cancel there if we take the other side. So I'll have 1 over 3 minus 1 over 4. But guys, press it. You can press your calculator. Don't remember, this thing doesn't use that. So just press it. Don't take short steps. Just press it to avoid mistakes. So we got D. It's 1 over 12. So now I have to substitute D back into my solution. So my Y will be X4 over 4 minus X cubed over 3 plus X plus 1 over 12. That's my final answer there. I hope it's clear. Okay, let's do the last one. Okay, the last one we have 1 over sin x times the second derivative equals to cot x plus e minus 2 minus 3x over sin x. Then the one particular solution, they gave you dy dx, they gave you x, they gave you y. So we know the first thing to do is to multiply both sides by sin x, because we need 1 here. So if I multiply here by sin x, we can see I'll be left with only the second derivative. If I multiply cot by sin, what will I be left with? Remember, cot is the same as cos over sin. So which means I'll be left with cos, because sin and sin will cancel. If I multiply here by sin, I'll be left with e minus 3x. See, so now let's work. So now integrate, I have first derivative. Integral of cos is positive sine. We know we will have to divide by the derivative, which is minus 3. E minus 3x plus c. So now we can quickly solve for c. What do we know? We know dy dx is 5 over 3. We know here we have sine 0, which is 0. We have minus 1 over 3. E minus 0, because x is 0, plus c. So I'll solve c quick. C will be 5 over 3 plus 1 over 3. So I'm having 2. My C is 2. If I didn't make any mistakes, it's 2. So now if I take it from here, from dy dx, I'm integrating again. I'll have y equals 2. The integral of sine is negative cos. The integral of e exponent minus 3 over x will make that positive 1 over 9 e minus 3x. The integral of c will be cx, but remember your c is 2, so this will be 2x plus d there. And the positive 1 over 9, I hope it's not confusing. Remember, the integral of e exponent minus 3 will be e exponent minus 3 over minus 3. Then that minus 3, remember, we also have minus 1 over 3, which will make it positive 1 over 9, which is this minus 1 over 3 here. Okay, so now we have to solve for D. They say Y is 1 over 9, X is 0, plus 1 over 9, E exponent 0, because X is 0, plus 2X, which is 0, D. So let me solve D. I can see 1 over 9 and 1 over 9 will cancel, so I'll be left with cos 0, which is 1. If I take it the other side, because it's negative cos 0. But remember, again, press your calculator to get proper. Don't try to simplify unless you also get it. So now we substitute our D on our main equation. This is our final answer then. And it's done. I hope this was very helpful. Okay, I'll see you next time, guys. Bye bye.